Sometimes you just gotta believe there's something that'll give you relief. There's something that'll have what you need. What you need. We're broken, it's tragic. We're not all elastic, but maybe there's magic. Believe you could have it. And I know of sadness, the anxious and panic, the infinite vastness of all that is blackness.
Of you that watch my videos daily, and so you understand my life. But for those of you who are new to my channel, I'm going to give you just a few moments to explain to you the title, My New Me, and then I'm going to be telling you what I'm working on that day. Why am I using the title My New Me? Well, it's very simple. In a little over a year, I lost two people that were the closest to me, two people that passed away. In this year, I had two surgeries, one oral surgery, and then I had one major surgery. And then in this year, I became very sick, and my husband became very sick as well. All of these took place in the last little over a year. So much of my life has happened. And through that all, I didn't miss a one video. I put out a video every single day, all through all of that. And keeping my house kept up, I kept it kept up on the surface, but deep down in the closets, in the cupboards, in the drawers, my house was a mess. All of the last year, I had tried so hard to just stay above everything, you know, just do what I possibly could. But what happened was, deep down inside my home, it was really suffering. Now, a lot of you who watch me on a daily basis would say, oh my word, that's not bad at all. But to me, it was. And I really, in this year, after we became sick and got better, I really focused on being thankful, focused on just changing my life, my new me. And I am a new me. I am a very new me. I am a new person. I am not the same person that I used to be. I am not the same person I was when I first started my YouTube channel. There are many parts of me that are the same, but there are many parts of me physically on the outside and on the inside are different. I need to be more specific. What did I lose? I lost myself. And as you all know, I've lost quite a bit of weight, and I want to give you a weight update. I haven't been doing that so often, but people have been noticing I'm still losing weight. I've lost over 60, 70 pounds, and I'm still losing weight. I'm not trying to lose weight in a way like, you know, I'm dieting or anything like that, but I regained myself back, and I'm reclaiming all the things that were taken from me. Everything that was taken from me, I allowed it to. I allowed these things to be taken from me because I allowed my emotions to over control my life. And I allowed the emotions of dealing with grief and dealing with stress. I used that as a way that I could eat. And so I would eat the stress, I would eat the emotions, I would eat the sorrow. See, I allowed all these things to be taken from me. I pretty much handed them over because I just stopped thinking about me. I stopped doing the things that I knew that gave me happiness. I stopped caring for myself. I let myself go. And that was because the stress of losing loved ones and eating all that stress, I ate it. You know, if I was feeling extra sad that day, well, then I could eat more ice cream. If I was feeling extra stressed that day, then I can eat some more brownies. And I replaced all of that stress eating into stress working and doing things that I enjoy. Thrifty Thursday is one of them. Instead of going and buying a half gallon of ice cream at the discount grocery store, Thrifty Thursday became my healing. You know, there is a thing about retail therapy. You know, people kind of tease about it and they say, oh, I'm depressed today, I'm gonna have retail therapy. Well, you know, that can really open up a can of worms where people can just spend everything and even then some. But there also is a thing about retail therapy and how, you know, you can take a couple dollars and do things that you enjoy. So that's what I've been doing. And then the videos upcoming starting Friday, I don't know when you're all gonna see them, but it's gonna be my new me because I took a new lease on life. I think when things happen in our lives, we can have two different points of view. We can be depressed, we can become very bitter, extremely bitter about it, and then we can become positive about it. And even though I tried doing that, I was so utterly sad and so much stress in my life that everything else was being taken care of, but not me. And there is a thing about, you know, self-preservation and taking care of yourself, because if you don't take care of yourself, nobody else is gonna do it for you. And so while I took care of myself, as you've seen in my videos, you've seen me transform. People say blossomed, you know, I transformed. I turned into somebody different because I grew and learned from it. Things in my home were being neglected. And now that's all part of, you know, what you think. Some people would say, that's not bad at all. Well, other people would say, oh yeah, that was, you know, that was rough. It's all in your perspective, you know? So what may be something I'm letting go, you may think is not letting go. It's just in your perspective. But I knew deep inside, for me as a person, there were things in my life that I was letting go. I wasn't taking care of them the way I should. I didn't have the energy. I didn't have the stamina. I didn't have the mental energy of it all. Now, don't get me wrong. I live an extremely stressful life with YouTube. YouTube is stressful. Making all the videos and doing all that. I work from home, but I work a high-paced life as far as, you know, the ways that I'm making income. You know, it's not easy. It's hard. No matter what you put into life, you're going to get out in return. And so I do put a lot into all of these income streams that I'm doing, and I'm reaping some success from it. And I'm really happy about that. But what happened with me inside happened way before all of these things were happening to me. I realized if I don't do something about myself, I'm going to be bitter. I'm going to be angry. I'm going to be depressed. And I'm going to live a very low quality life. Low quality life to me is nothing physical. It's mental and it is your emotions. You can have a physical 100% body and still have a very low quality of life. And that is because you left yourself go mentally and emotionally, and that you're just bitter. You can go to the grocery store or anywhere in public and you can see people who have a low quality life, even though on the outside they look perfect, because you can tell by their spirit. They're just extremely dissatisfied in life and they are extremely bitter and angry at the world. I decided I'm going to let my lights in my eyes shine, and I was going to be a new me. And so I hope that you're encouraged in these following videos that are to come, because they encouraged me as I worked through them. It's a lot of work, a lot of effort, but boy, oh boy, did it reap some great rewards. Take care, everyone. And like I said, buckle those seatbelts, because it's going to be a very interesting ride. Bye, everybody.